Hi, welcome to another exciting video where I wanted to show you the out-of-box experience and setup of the G7500. So as you can see, it's now connected up to a Dell touchscreen, and on top we see the EcoIQ USB. And as you see, when you start up the unit and connect it to the network, you see directly the IP address that it will get, and you will see the username admin, and the password are the last six digits of the serial number. So this is the out-of-boxing and the setup of the G7500. So now you need to go to your browser and walk through the setup, and I will show you that. So as soon as you get the username and password from the screen, you go to your laptop and open up the IP address into the browser onto the group 7500. There you put in the admin and the last six digits of the serial number, and you sign in, and the first thing it will ask you is to change the password. So we will change the password to a new password. All right, we acknowledge the license agreement. So the next step will be the provisioning information. So if you set up the DHCP correctly, it will automatically find the resource manager or the PDMS to set it up. So if I click on provisioning, you will see that it didn't detect any information from the DHCP. Here you can fill in all the information to register to your central management. But for now, I will do a manual setup just to walk you through. So if you do manual, you choose your location. I just keep it by default United States. The G7500 is a room name, we'll keep that by default. The security code, so this is when you connect wirelessly and using AirPlay or Miracast, it will ask you for the security code to connect, and it's recommended to use that. You can always turn it off later on if you want. And here you go, we are finished. So as soon as you walk through the setup wizard, you will land on the dashboard of the G7500. Now what you will notice is on this dashboard, you have a quick overview of all the details of the unit, the software version, MAC address. You can grab network or usage settings of the box. On the top right, we got all the different sort of made up quick links to the different settings. So it gives also the green and red light, what is aware of issues or when the registration is not correctly. And down right, you see a quick dial function. So here you can punch in the meeting room ID and dial a video or a voice into a quick meeting. Very handy. It looks almost similar as we had with the group series, but the G7500 has of course some newer features and functionality, like the IP based connected devices. So here under the general settings, device management, you can find all the devices connected, and also the current software version of those connected microphones. There's auto pairing enabled, so as soon as you connect the device to the G7500, it will pair. So it makes it all very easy. Also the software versions are going over IP, so if you look at the manageability of the devices, it's very, very easy. Now, as the G7500 has a built-in wireless sharing functionality, what also is nice is that you can tweak that. So the G7500 has AirPlay and Miracast built-in. You can tweak the different channels. So if you got multiple devices in a building, you can tweak the listening port and the operating channel of the Miracast. So that is all very nice. So wireless connectivity and wireless content sharing is built into the G7500. Very powerful. Also, as you see here, security code. So recommended is to turn this on, so it will require request a pin code. When somebody tries to share it, we'll show it on the screen, and then people can share. Now further, we can add this device into a provisioning environment. So if you got the PDMS or the resource manager, you can, in case you have like a baseline G7500, you can download those settings and then import them in your resource manager. And then if you got other systems being rolled out, it's just a matter of using that template and it will get the identical settings. Does the end user experience look like? First of all, what is very important for the user is when they walk into the room, they just want to able to quickly start the meeting by just pressing a join button. And as you can see here also, I've added here all the join buttons here on the screen. So a user is able to walk in and just press a join button. But how do you get this functionality on the screen? And this is what I quickly wanted to show you. So Poly has the One Touch Dial functionality. That's a service from the cloud. And you can use that not only on your G7500, but also on your current group series or your trio. You're able to join any type of meetings. So let me give you a quick snap of that interface. So here I wanted to show you a quick snap of the One Touch Dial functionality in the cloud. As I said, that this is a service in the cloud, but what it does, it will give you the One Touch Dial functionality on your Poly endpoints. So as you see here, there's BlueJeans integration, Zoom, Videxio, Microsoft Link, Skype for Business, Teams, FireRail Connect. There's like almost any service that is out there is able to parse through the One Touch Dial service. And this is the trick. This gives you the One Touch Dial functionality on your video endpoint. And I think this is very powerful. So when you got those meetings there on the top, how easy it is to join them. And so you see here, I got some different meetings here, a Rail Connect call, a Zoom call, etc. But it can be anything. Now, joining a meeting is just really just pressing join, and it will automatically dial into the call. Now, as soon as you are in a call, I think that's also very powerful. It's really just a matter of using the controls. And so the controls are right here. So underneath you can set the layout, add participants, camera control, volume, and hang up the call. And so you got all kinds of options during the call to work on your session. Now, on the other end, we also have here some buttons which you can use. So you got here place a call, where you can just quickly dial into a meeting using the keypad, or for example using favorites. So you can build some favorites as I've done here, for Zoom, BlueJeans, WebEx, or Videxio, or Teams via Rail Connect. Any type of service you can put them in here as favorites just to quickly dial into those meetings. And you can see that the interface works really fast. It's just a matter of walking in and quickly punch to the service that you want to use. Now, another button which I wanted to show you is the usage of content. So not only HDMI input, but this device also has built-in sharing for AirPlay and Miracast. And of course on the right side you see the Poly Content app. This is also an app which runs on Windows or on Apple. And in case you you don't have Miracast or AirPlay, you can always use this app as a fallback. Now, but how does this Miracast work? Now, for example, you are an AirPlay company and you want to share some designs about a new engine. Well, on your Windows device, this is really easy. You can use the built-in Miracast functionality. And that's really easy. You just press the Windows button with the K, and this will pop up all the Miracast devices that are in the neighborhood. Now, let me show you. So I'm just pressing here on my keyboard, Windows K, and now here on the right side you will get a list of all the devices. I will search for my device here, that's the Hoofddorp Delft, and I will start sharing. And also, of course, you can put a pin code on this if you want, but now you should see my screen. Here you go, on the G7500. Now the only thing I need to do, as my sharing is now also a second screen, so this is very handy when you have PowerPoints. I will move this to the right and you will see my screen popping up over there. So I have now here shared the new engine here with the team. And don't forget that when I was in a call now, for example with Zoom or BlueJeans or Teams via Real Connect or Fidexio, like any of those ecosystem partners, you will share this design. Now, what is very powerful with the G7500, and I think you might have noticed this here on the left side, you see several tooling. So on the top, we have a tool to with a pen where you can make different types of pens. You can have a magic marker, which I will show you, a marker to remove. We got different colors here. You can go backwards, you can make a snapshot. So if you click that one, I can create a snapshot. So if you've done some annotation there, you will get your snapshot there. You can call them back later. Here's your blackboard and whiteboard, and of course help functionality. So always, if you want to know all the options that are possible, just click the help button. Here you can go and zoom in and zoom out, etc. It's really, really powerful. Now with the magic marker, I really like that one. The magic marker means the longer you write, the longer it will stay. So for example, I want to talk about a specific part of the engine. So if I do that quickly, the magic marker will go away quickly. But in case I do this slowly, so I got the yellow one, and I wanted to talk about this bigger piece of the engine, which is very important. What you will notice now is that this line will stay longer, so I can talk longer about this specific part of the engine. And this is what I really, really like. So I'm using now one touchscreen, but you can imagine if you got dual touchscreens. On one screen, somebody can share with his Miracast using his laptop, and on the other screen, somebody can share from his AirPlay device, so his iPad or his MacBook, etc. And I hope to show you that in another video in the future. But now, I just wanted to show you how the great experience is of the GS7500 just by itself, using on one screen. Now, you can see all your annotations here, and you can also save them if you got the Pano app, and you can also save all the annotations. So I can create a snapshot and call back the different engines. So if I made some annotations here, so you can also make some fixed annotations. So we discussed this, we discussed that, so we had a great discussion about all those different pieces, and so these annotations will stay. And I can also create a snapshot of that, and that will come here underneath in the bar, which can be saved back to my PC using the Pano app. Very, very powerful. Now, at the end, when you're finished, you can always end your session right there. So if you click on end session, it will say continue session or end session. So if I click on end my session, all the content will be removed. So nothing is reusable by any other user walking into this room. Now, that was the Miracast functionality. Of course, you can always start your Blackboard if you want. So if you click on the blackboard, you come again into this functionality. So here you can just quickly grab an item and discuss some items if you want very quickly, and just walk them through. So this could be very handy during a quick brainstorm session, where you can just quickly discuss several items. Now, this was just a quick setup video and user experience video of the GS7500. So let me know if you have any questions, and otherwise I just recommend to visit one of our Poly experience centers where you can see this G7500 live.